Hey, everybody. This podcast might be a little late. That's because we tried last night. We really tried our best.
It still doesn't feel like a reality. It's an odd feeling. We fucked with this strange guy named Goat vs. Fish, and it'll be on Patreon.
We brought Goat vs. Fish on the show. Some of you, the hardcore amongst you, might know who he is.
Oh, yeah, they will.
I don't know. I don't think we've talked about him really on the air, but if you went to my very first stand-up show, which was in the fall of 2019, you would have seen him perform live.
Yeah.
This guy's entire shtick consists of going up on stage with a Burger King crown and a Beanie Baby goat and a Beanie Baby fish resting within that crown. He's got two towels covering his body, and he just talks about goats and fishes nonstop.
Yeah, and he has his own language almost. It's like a weird fucked up pig Latin type thing.
Yeah.
Where he says verses.
It's
all
a
the
pigeon.
Time.
It's an English goat versus fish pigeon.
Yeah.
And he, Leo, is unwilling to break character, isn't he now?
Oh, yeah. But he was very willing to show his cock, which was possibly one of the funniest things I've ever seen in my life.
I just want to say, like, we tried sincerely for the duration of his stay on the podcast.
Yeah.
I think an hour and 45 minutes, we tried to get him to be like, we tried to just get him to be honest with us.
Right.
Why have you chosen to dedicate your entire comedic life? No, scratch that. Your entire life period to this goat versus fish thing, which I don't get.
No one does.
It's vaguely amusing when he's up on stage doing it, but the novelty wears off maybe 30 seconds into the set. Yeah. And I told him straight up, hey, you got to adjust course on your comedic journey. I did it when I used to write books, and then I got into YouTube, and then you have to adjust course when you're doing the YouTube, see what content's working, what's not. Goat versus fish, that character needs to be lynched.
No,
not the guy, the character.
Guy's great. Character, he needs to adjust. I mean, look, he's really trying to, I think, outwork everybody. He wants to do it for 25 years and get, you know, very little views on very little traction, but eventually, somehow, he thinks he's going to blow up.
That's like the guy who is trying to breed the strongest horses in the early 1900s, and Henry Ford says, you know what, fuck that, here's a motor car.
Yeah, now what are you going to do?
You got to evolve.
Yeah, you got to evolve.
Fuck horses.
Yeah, stand-up is like hanging on somehow still, you know, the Netflix, you know, pushes stuff, there's still big comedians, but yeah, it's you know, going to YouTube is the new way to fucking really blow up in the comedy world now.
Yeah. Yeah. That's why everybody's on me and Leo's nuts.
Yeah, dude, it's true, man. I shouldn't be on all these I shouldn't be on all these shows, to be completely honest. But I am because I'm a draw, baby. Danny, dude, you could just go straight to the Laugh Factory if you really want. Dude,
well,
you could
so could Fangeri, apparently.
God damn it. In San Diego, though. That one doesn't, it's new. They're trying to blow it up. That doesn't count. Although it is still pretty awesome that he got to perform at the Laugh Factory. Most people will never.
No,
but the Laugh Factory, wait. San Diego.
Yeah.
It's not the fucking official one. You can't give him that much credit. It's a brand new place. They really are trying to bring. He is a bringer, is what they call it.
Okay.
It's a bringer is Fangeri. So a bringer is really the little bitch of the comedy world. It's like, hey, little bitch.
Damn.
You got to bring 5 to 10 people or you can't perform.
Sure.
And you're only getting 5 minutes.
Sure.
I talked to Ali. He's getting 5 minutes. That's it.
Yeah. Fangeri has been talking nonstop shit about me and the rest of the crew all summer. It culminated in, I'll say it, it was a delightful TikTok video.
It was the funniest thing.
It was the funniest video that anybody's made about how much they hate me.
Who could sing the song a little? I want to hear it a little bit.
Who was singing it? Somebody sang it to me recently, and I was amazed they memorized
the
lyrics.
I don't know the song.
It doesn't matter.
Dino, do you know the fucking song? Fuck off, Dino.
Dino doesn't know the lyrics to his favorite song. He's too high to remember those.
He thinks he's Kobe right now.
Dude,
he's got a Lakers jersey.
He does look like Kobe.
So Fangeri, I saw on some post that he's performing at the Laugh Factory in San Diego. Good for him. But I'm just saying that let's not put
this thing.
If any part of the corporation is putting Fangeri on the planks and giving him a mic, it can't be that credible, can it? No,
the thing is that putting people in seats is basically the number one most important thing for a comedy show because you need people there to really perform. So they have to put some people on there that are meant to just be a draw. And you, for example, they wouldn't even have to see like a tape. Usually you need like submit a tape or go to an open mic, like the ones that has been going to Go versus Fish for years, doing his fucking act. But if you can draw, honestly, 10 to 20, if that's considered a lot. But if you can draw 40, 30, you're fucking D'Elia. You know what I mean?
Economics, pure economics.
Just monetary.
Goat versus Fish, the lone entertaining moment that we were able to achieve with him is when, I don't know, it was impenetrable, his goat versus fish thing. Mm. And Leo kept feeding into it.
I just kept falling for it.
He kept getting sucked in. Leo would ask him these genuine questions. And in my head, I would go, Leo, do you think he's going to answer this with anything other than, goat versus fish is, methinks, the goat versus fish multiverse. Or, however, it always has to do with guess who, a goat or a fish.
Or a fish,
yeah. And the one thing that seemed to pique his interest and let him momentarily break out of his goat and fishy shell was when I showed him my nutsack. Don't remember the context. But then he started, I had moved on. I was trying my best to ignore him and focus on something else we were talking about, maybe Columbus Day.
It was the
boner kid. Started offering, goat versus fish thinks you, fence sitter, just showed me your fishy testicles. Me thinks me must reciprocate with my verses. And I'd gotten used to his language by this point. So I could sift through all the nonsense and say, did you just offer to show me your penis?
Yeah.
And he said, oh, goat versus fish versus. He goes over here, just springs up, pirouettes across the floor, gets in the opening of the bathroom door, and just exposes himself to me and Leo, and we laugh for 30 straight seconds.
It was incredibly funny.
The hardest I've laughed in a while.
It was one of those, like, I couldn't talk for about, you know, like a good minute because I was laughing pretty hard. So it'll still be an entertaining episode for those that have the Patreon. But we wanted to put something a little bit more normal on the channel.
It was pretty niche, far too niche for the general audience that consumes the podcast on YouTube. But we got Swolby One Kenobi in the house.
What up?
Wearing his Blue Lives Matter t-shirt, his Uncle Sam hat. He's a good patriotic Mongolian Mexican.
Another man who doesn't plan his shit, Danny, because he took another shit in your little tiny bathroom.
Had to.
Okay, so he's the opposite of that, Leo. He's planning his shits very carefully and planning them all to drop into my porcelain.
Right there, yeah. Why, dude? You got to wake up early and have your first morning coffee.
It doesn't
get
work
the fucking
like that,
diuretic. Yeah.
What's your deal with me? Why are you
like
trying
that
to shit in my toilet at every opportunity?
Because it hits me when I get here, okay?
You got to be.
The nerves hit me, and then I got to drop in there like fucking Hiroshima.
That's nice, actually. If it's the nerves, but really, you got to be one of the top shitters in this house. That's not a guy that lives here. You're not non-roommate shitting.
No, Fish God.
Fish God just comes in here and takes massive shits.
My friends have this fat buddy of theirs who's one of the top seafood exporters in the nation.
That guy's awesome.
And he comes over here, and the toilet looks like it's a construction worker's porta potty.
Oh my God!
After he's done.
Why is it the construction workers just drop huge fucking shit loads?
Because they eat like shit. Their lunch pail consists of hot Cheetos, a hot dog, and then a Pepsi Cola.
Do you think there's... honestly, there's probably a lot of construction workers that have that kind of a meal. We should try to call a construction site and ask for their lunch options.
Construction workers are classic. Somewhere out there, you know, construction workers are oblivious to Me Too. They're like the guy who was on that small island in the Pacific who didn't know World War II was over.
Yeah.
You know those guys are out there. They're dangling from the scaffolding. They see a hottie walk by, even in San Francisco or New York. Hey, sugar tits! Woo! Show us some leg, darling! Show us some leg!
Oh, my God.
You know, they just are oblivious to all the Me Too, Joe Biden. You know what? Fuck Joe Biden. I saw this piece of shit last night. If anybody still likes Joe Biden...
He's gotten Me Too.
I respect him a little bit more.
Yeah, exactly.
But I just saw Joe Biden was the first president to officially anoint Indigenous Peoples Day. This guy is just... He is just a geriatric, bumbling fool who's fucking things up overseas, fucking things up abroad, and he just comes out of the woodwork every 2 weeks to do something politically correct, and then he disappears again.
I'm worried about him because he's getting close to seeing those pearly gates. Maybe he's going to hell. I don't know, but he's going to see Columbus wherever he goes. Columbus ain't going to be too happy about this bullshit.
The Catholic Church said they don't fuck with him no more.
Joe Biden?
Basically, yeah, because of his
abortion
stance. Joe Biden.
Because of his
stance? Fuck with Columbus.
Because his stance on abortion.
Yeah.
We had a good talk about religion last night, and it made me really, really want to go to... Maybe I'm going to go to church with Dino and Austin. It's a small church in Calabasas, Danny.
It's good.
They said we could spy cam it.
Nice.
We could spy cam it up.
I'm down. Yeah, we can. I mean, the church is just...
It's a tough one.
It's a great organization. I mean, they've now been accused of molesting 300,000 young boys.
That's as many college baseball players as there are in the United States. 300,000. That's crazy.
At that point, It seems as if their purpose, their essential function, is not to praise Christ, but to fuck asshole.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, young asshole.
It's interesting. I feel like the Catholic religion, like I've always said, it's my favorite because you can just repent. You know what I mean? So I think that's what they're feeling. They're like, you know what? I'm going to do this now.
Mm-hmm.
Finger some assholes now. Mm-hmm. But I can always just ask for forgiveness. And if I really mean it, and you know they work on that character. They really speak to God, you know? Mm-hmm. So they know.
They're good actors.
They're good actors. Mm-hmm. They know. They think they're going to be able to fool God. But mm-hmm. God ain't gonna let them in mm-hmm. to the pearly gates.
Why are they all gay? Like, why don't they get altar girls? Couldn't they have made that an institution?
I think the thing is, like, okay, so have you ever
The pedophilia is what I'm saying. Totally get it. Just why not make it straight pedophilia?
Okay, so one of my roommates in college, I'm not gonna say his name, but he...
Say his name, first and last.
His name is Justin. I don't think he doesn't have an Instagram, so you guys couldn't find him anyway. He is now a chaplain at a church. All right, so basically the step below the priest.
That's you went to such a screwy college.
I did.
That's
dude.
Bound to happen. There's bound to be a random chaplain.
He's a virgin, and he might be gay, Danny, because one time I put his background on his windows. I think I've told this story before, but many moons ago. I put the background. It was a girl bending over, and her vagina and asshole were out, right?
Nice vagina and asshole?
Oh, very nice. Okay. So he walks in, and this is what he says verbatim. He sees it, and he goes, oh, you can see her snatch from behind. And we were all, what the fuck just came out of your fucking mouth,
well,
dude?
Well, he knew the word snatch.
Snatch, yeah, but I feel like that's what his mom would call it or something. But either way,
it's
he
a
was
strange mom.
Right? He was really thrown back by it. And he might.
Justin, I need to go to CVS to get some tampons for my snatch.
I think it's more like, watch out for those snatches out there, Justin. Don't you make sure they'll bite back.
I think you're just misremembering. I think he came in and said, oh, you can see her vagina from behind. I think you just put your own word into the memory.
Maybe.
And also, Leo, right now, I got a couple things to say to you. I got to send this photo to Austin. There's no way I'm going to remember to do this. And it's always, our technology on this podcast is so garbage. The process of sending Austin a picture, because he's got an Android, because he's a numbskull, you have to email him a photo, and it takes 45 minutes to travel 3 feet across the room.
Hey, if you texted it to me, I'd have to email it to myself anyways.
There we go. But Leo put up a story this weekend. This is the new tangent I'm going on right now.
Oh,
Leo and
God.
Chicks. Leo put up a story on his Instagram this weekend at a comedy show with two girls, tagging them, basically just giving them a shout out in order to gain favor for an eventual hypothetical blowjob.
Close.
Oh, God. You know what I did? It was more business. It was more of a business decision, Danny. I wanted to do it so that the little fans are like, oh, look. Leo brings girls that are, you know, age appropriate for me, being college kid, to go and hang out with, which is what I always do. I always tell Swolby, come to the comedy shows. There'll be some pussy there, right?
There was some pussy.
There was some pussy. So, but it wasn't for the eventual blowjob. I've never even, I've been friendly with those girls. But I mean, look, if
friendly meaning you applied half the usual pressure on the back of their head.
Exactly. Yeah. I didn't use.
You're a good girl. Oh, fuck the nice guy routine. Suck it, whore. Suck it.
Jesus Christ.
That's just 50%.
The truth is, I at least offered my own hair tie, you know, to hold the hair back, at least.
Nice.
You know what I mean? I didn't just use my hand and, you know, just pull.
A gentleman.
Yeah. I'm a gentleman. Thank you.
And
thank you.
And you buried her head after you decapitated her.
Oh, you sick son of a bitch.
Usually you just throw it in the L.A. River.
Oh, my God.
What if Leo just got...
I'm a serial murderer, dude. A serial killer.
Yeah, it's
we'll
possible.
We'll have one that of those explains. In the crew eventually.
I mean, if not... Okay, there are two candidates to be a serial killer in this room. It's you and Dino. It's definitely...
It's got to be Dino, dude. It's more Dino. No, he loves animals. I love animals. You see me with Brando, dude? I can't be a murderer. We got to talk to somebody like... There's got to be a sick fuck who's like messed up animals.
I think I've told this story somewhere on my Patreon. I do live streams on here. We do two shows a week. Did I tell you about the worm Titanic?
No.
Oh, no.
What the fuck is this?
I think I've heard this before.
Okay, maybe Austin
has. What the fuck is this?
It might have been a Patreon episode I did with Austin, but... When I was younger, I was one of those kids who would kill bugs.
It's okay. I used to do it too.
But it got elaborate with me.
Oh, God.
Elaborate to the level of being creepy. One day, I got home from eighth grade science, And we'd learned to make very sturdy paper boats in that particular class.
That's fun.
How to shape the hull right, how to get the equation right for volume and buoyancy. So I made myself a real nice destroyer-sized paper boat and put it in my swimming pool.
Oh, God.
I was happy to see it floated terrifically. But I realized it was missing a crew. It was missing passengers.
Oh, my God.
And thankfully, if I remember, it was the fantastic month of February.
Oh, boy.
There had been rains. And whenever there are rains where I'm from, there are plenty of earthworms squiggling about the sidewalk or the pavement. There's no sidewalk.
They're very good for the soil. They provide a great fertilizer.
Yeah, well, they make good fuel for a fire, too, Leo.
Oh, my God.
I got two handfuls of earthworms. I put them aboard the HMS Third Degree Burns, and I shoved him out to shore, but not before I lit the corner of the boat on fire.
You sick son of a bitch.
So it floated out to the middle of my Doughboy above ground swimming pool and just slowly burned with a full worm
cargo. I know a couple survived.
That would be pretty tough where they can just live on the bottom of a pool.
Well, you know, I don't know. I feel like
Ishmael. It's like Moby Dick.
A book about it. In my mind, there was some heroic like bird. There was another species that helped that swooped down. It was a bird, obviously, and got a couple of them. And you know what? Decided to save one.
So
and that one went on to have a family.
You're saying a sparrow has more empathy than me.
Absolutely.
It cared more about the worms.
To defend you a little bit, I did the magnifying thing with the fucking... Mm-hmm. That's so fucked up. Mm-hmm. Can you even imagine being an ant and this light of just straight fierce... heat just completely just demolishes you. That is so evil too. And I did that because I saw it in a fucking cartoon.
Yeah,
I saw it in Ants, the movie Ants.
Yeah,
they shouldn't have showed us that.
It was bad. The Woody Allen movie.
Yes, the Woody Allen movie. I saw it there, and I was like, oh my God, can you really do this?
What do you got, Swolby?
I fried a goldfish when I was in middle school.
Oh, how'd you do that? See, I feel like you're working up the ladder of cuteness.
Yeah.
Leo is the least bad because ants, you can't even make out their facial expression. Right. Worms don't have faces, but they're kind of big, so right. I agree. It was fucked up what I did.
Yeah.
Goldfish have big, cute eyes. So tell me your story, Swolby, and I might ban you from the podcast if
I
don't like
fucking,
it.
Mudflap ate it. He swallowed a fucking goldfish. That was pretty fucked up.
Mudflap is always so drunk. He doesn't really have the ability to know.
The goldfish
right from wrong.
Survived in his stomach for fucking months. It's still probably okay.
I hope it had babies. What's going on, Swolby?
I just pulled it out the tank because I bought it at Petco, like, a week prior to that, and then I just was looking at it. I was bored because I didn't have a babysitter.
How old were you?
How old are you?
I don't like where this is going.
I was like 11, 12.
Okay.
And I didn't have a babysitter during the summer. So my mom would just work, and I just watched the goldfish, and I was like, fuck this. So I just grab it, and I start frying it. I like heat up the fucking... stove.
Oh my
God.
Swolby, what the fuck?
Put some
also, I love the thought process. This goldfish is alive. My mom isn't home. Fuck this.
Yeah.
It therefore must die.
Yeah, what the fuck, man?
So I just lit it up. Just
did you
watched
feel bad?
It burn. Yeah, I did. I felt bad like an hour later.
Well, obviously, your fucking goldfish was dead.
That is the worst one.
Well, I think Derek might win, maybe.
Uh oh.
Derek, did you hurt a mammal?
Derek,
you're a mammal, bro.
Derek,
oh my God, what'd you do to a mammal?
He is
when
the serial
Derek
killer.
Was really little, we had this dog.
Oh no.
And it bit Derek. So in retaliation,
no.
He threw the puppy over our balcony.
What?
Down to
it's
the first
up,
floor.
Dude.
It survived.
Yeah, it was fine. But it hit the ground and freaked out for a minute and ran around like crazy. And
how many stories were you up?
Derek, do you even remember doing this?
He was so young. Make sure to pick up the mic when you talk.
How old were you when you did this?
I don't remember.
He was probably like 5 or 6.
How many stories?
It was one. It wasn't.
So you were on the second floor.
I wasn't trying to kill.
Yeah, he was on the second floor, and he threw the dog to the first floor, and it went boing, and then fucking ran around.
What kind of dog was it?
A schnauzer, like a puppy schnauzer.
What? That bite couldn't have even hurt.
Dino, you're a sick son of a bitch.
You are.
Stupid kid.
You hurt a puppy.
Jesus.
Hey, you know what? In fact, I almost want you to call one of your parents and ask, you know, tell them that you want to open with this at church and ask for forgiveness from God for doing this. Mm.
And I mean, just think of it this way. It wasn't as bad as Cigar Guy who fucked his poodle.
Yeah, that's true. He had sex. He had sex with a dog, and he told his parents about it.
That's more scarring than just getting thrown off a balcony. The dog probably kind of liked it. Maybe he was the Travis Pastrana of the Schnauzer world.
Honestly,
he liked to catch some air.
You could have started his stunt career. He's fine now.
Mm-hmm.
He's probably making SAG scale, mm-hmm. 1200 beyond set.
Little apartment in Brentwood.
Yeah.
That dog,
fully owned.
Yeah, he's hanging out. He's getting so much pussy right now. Mm-hmm.
That dog also got smoked by a coyote. So that makes two
God
cats.
Damn it, dog. Dude!
Damn.
Wow, you guys get out. I mean, dude, in LA, nobody leaves like any dog that's not. You got to be a coyote. They're not that big. Like a medium to large dog can it'll scare it away. But unless they come in packs, but. Any small dog or a cat, you can't fuck with. They'll get smoked in any of the hills in L.A.
That one was back in Texas, too.
Dino, you should try eating these instead of your Takis.
What the hell is that?
They're just these chips we got. They're pretty fucking good.
They look like Pringles.
They're fucking
I'm
bomb.
I'm hungry, dude.
That looks like a prank.
Wait, no. Get over here.
I got no warrant. Wait, no.
Get over here. Try.
This is a trick.
Mm-mm.
No,
this
dude.
Be terrible.
If it was a trick, we would have showed you them much earlier, asshole. You think I have that kind of discipline?
Here, give the camera to Swolbs.
It's fucking legit.
Just
here.
Put it down. It's okay. I got a camera on Dino. Just toss it to him.
All right.
Yeah, we got a camera on Dino. Oh, he's going to come over here.
Okay.
Here you go, buddy.
They're fucking tasty, dude. Read the nutritional facts.
It's a brand that I saw at Big Lots a lot. They were a close-up, but they're like better than Pringles. In
absolutely. It's a little family from Idaho that puts them together.
Yeah, exactly. They're actually, they don't use canola oil. They use like natural oils.
Yeah, and there is no MG.
GMOs?
There is no, what's the salt thing?
Oh, fuck, I don't know. We're
God
retarded.
Damn it.
God damn it.
I hate being on the spot.
Just
MSG.
MSG. There's zero MSG.
There's zero MSG.
There's zero MSG.
Damn it!
This is the worst prank thing ever, dude.
Wait!
What the fuck is that? Danny, god damn it!
Fail.
I thought the lid was
worst bit ever!
He fell for it, too. He opened it.
We tried to get Dino for the fuck with the Pringles can that has a snake in it, but instead, it didn't come out.
I could tell that was a prank can.
What did you put in it?
I used to wear
it. What was the projectile you put in it?
Austin, you realize...
Telling
Dino wrong, that it looks like a prank can adds nothing
thanks
to the show.
Thanks a lot, Austin.
Well, at first I didn't actually think it was. I just said it looked like one, and then when I said that, I went, "Oh yeah, it is."
It
one.
Is one. Obviously,
you can tell by the lid.
Yeah, like
what
fucking.
Kind of lid is that?
We're all so impressed. But to get back to Leo's pussy moves right now, he's currently direct messaging an OnlyFans girl. We're trying to get her to the podcast to get her titties out. But what did she say? Can you read the conversation?
Sure. She's trying to fuck. She's not an entrepreneur. I'm trying to give her. A fucking
can I
chance.
Read it?
Yeah, you
let me
can
see
read
it
from the top. There's no internet
minded.
Connection. It's not. Fuck this. There it is. There it is. Come back. Come back. So there you go.
Okay. So we've got a girl.
So she adds me late last night. Looks kind of like a real profile. It says it's private, but it's got the OnlyFans. She's got over 2,000 followers, a good 9-10 posts, and then, you know, a few. She's following only a few people. So it looks like a real profile.
She follows Kobe Person,
and
too.
He follows her, yeah. So.
Kobe Person is an old-school prank YouTuber who got lots of views by doing lookalike pranks and the typical 2012 to 2014 stuff. I looked at his profile recently, and he's gone off the deep end with like trying to be a pretty boy.
Yeah, he really wants to be a pretty boy now, yeah.
It's ridiculous. All of his pictures are airbrushed, and he's got his abs out.
He looks good, man.
He might even have some filler in his face.
Gay.
You know... Swolby, you could say that. I mean, look, if a guy's getting pussy, I can't judge. You know,
they
what
look
I mean?
Like my Instagram photos.
Nah, even they're like TikTok level.
More gay.
Yeah.
Okay, so Leo opens. Leo, you fucking dirtbag. Leo opens. This girl adds him. Leo says, "Hey, your bio is funny." She says, "True, but funny." This is her bio.
It's terrible.
Taurus. I make great content. Mm-hmm. Miss Independent. Mm-hmm. I hate broke people.
That's such that's a stupid, good. It's a terrible bio.
Well, I guess, I mean, we talk a lot of shit on the homeless in here, so we're kind of on board with that.
Yeah.
They're broke, right?
Yeah.
I love dudes with long hair, and I seen you on Recommended, so I gave you a follow. Nothing makes my testes shrivel like a woman saying, I seen
you.
There used to be these goatee-clad... house painters that I used to play paintball with when I was a kid. There was one of them named Gavin.
Mm-hmm.
Gavin, which is such a white trash name. He had an orange goatee, buck teeth, And he would be like, hey, Danny, I seen you running by me and I tried to shoot you, but you were running too fast. That would be Gavin's conversation after a game of paintball.
It's like the equivalent to like the Indian guy that slides into every chick's DMs.
Yeah, dude, those guys are the horniest guys of all time.
What do they say?
They're like, they just blast their fucking inbox with, hey, hi, hey.
Your ex probably had to deal with that shit. Yeah, the horny Indian guys are the most classic guys on the internet.
Dude, so
there's a billion of them.
We're going to get back to Stacy.
Literally a billion.
We're going to get back to Stacy here, but this is an interesting fact that'll prove that the Indians are complete horn dog perverts. A lot of my old videos where it's me making out with a something in the thumbnail, an old lady, a girl in Walmart.
Bunch of Indians, huh?
Those still go viral. Those are always generating thousands of views a month. And I look up the demographics for the viewership. The main channel videos are about 60 to 70% USA viewership, followed by maybe 10% UK and 10% Canada, and the rest is all Scandinavian countries. Mm-hmm. The Kiss videos... The second highest viewership is Indian.
Wow. What? I think I'm going to start tailoring my channels strictly to the Indians. I might just do an only makeout videos every single week.
I don't know if they spend money, though, Leo. So it might not be
I don't think they do at all. No, that's the problem.
Okay, so she's seen you on her recommended. Mm-hmm. My job is to promote my OnlyFans and have people buy my packages. If you're local, I have a Big Daddy package. We can record for my OnlyFans. Mm-hmm. Would love to. Your hair is amazing. She's really hung up on your fucking hair.
She really likes it.
Hey, I love in the main channel video this week when that guy burned you as being all hair and no substance.
Yeah, fuck that guy, dude. Fuck that guy.
Where
dude.
Are you located? I'm in Pasadena. Nice. I'm in LA. West Hollywood. Are you even technically in West Hollywood?
Yeah, that's right. But yeah, absolutely. I'm in West Hollywood.
Okay, sure. She sent you a video. What's that?
She sent me a video of her holding her titties like this and just kind of looking sexy.
Wow, that was aggressive of her.
Yeah, already.
How old are you? There's Leo doing his due diligence. Yep, that was unsolicited, her photo. Mm-hmm. I'm 24, sweetie. I have a podcast I'm doing right now. Can we call you on it? Ha ha, no podcast, please. I mean, if you purchased my package, I would be down.
Idiot.
It couldn't hurt me. I'm still getting paid.
Yeah.
You can promote it on your OnlyFans. We'll talk about some other stuff. Since you're local, it's a one-time pay. Includes lots of things. An overnight stay. I was talking, but this girl's a prostitute.
She literally is, yeah.
Leo, you should tell her. I got a
package
for you. Okay, so this... I got a package. I'm trying to get her on the fucking pod, dude. She doesn't get the entrepreneurial...
What are you talking about? I get 50K lessons a week? What is
listens,
that?
Listens,
listens.
Listens. I said lessons? Fuck.
Okay,
She says, I get 50K lessons a week? She's going to be like, what is this guy?
She says, so quit being lame and purchase my package. It's a win-win. Listen, you fucking...
Stop it. Stop it. She'll me too me, dude. She'll me too me for showing me her tits, dude. That's how it works now. Don't do it.
Okay. I'm just going to send her a picture of me.
Yeah. Just send her a picture out of nowhere. You send her like a fuckboy picture, like an ab picture, though? I like it.
I sent her a photo of my middle finger up.
Yeah, I like it.
Yeah, that's all she's getting. All
right, good.
All right, you got lucky. I was going to send her something really, really dirty.
The brains?
She complicated things by sending that titty picture.
Were you going to send her the brains, dude?
Is that my nuts?
Yeah.
No.
Let's call them, it would have been a smart
move. It would have been a really smart move because then she just would have thought they were your nuts, and I wouldn't have been liable from a Me Too standpoint.
You think there's girls out there who just want to see some a nutsack?
I think they would be the girl of... I would be the man of their dreams if that were the case.
Yeah, we should get Nutsack Ned and this endless boner guy to talk to each other on the phone. That would be fucking
cool. What should we do with Nutsack Ned? We should bring Nutsack Ned in here, and we should do arts and crafts on his big nut. We should paint it like you would paint a gourd for Halloween.
Oh, my God. I mean, there's so much surface on that nutsack. You can easily do so much. I don't know what we would do. I don't know. We could draw every continent. We could make it look like the Earth.
We could put googly eyes on it and make it into a sock puppet.
We could
give away the painting to a lucky fan.
We could make
sever his testicle. You understand that, Swolby, right?
I kind of like the idea of making it into a giant eight ball. Just a all black. It's almost do blackface on his nuts.
Yeah, I like that too. Sort of like when I had a retainer when I was younger, you had a choice of the camouflage retainer, the American flag, the eight ball. We're doing a similar thing with his nuts.
Exactly.
We should make him show up with a different testicle decoration for every shoot he's on.
We could get a makeup artist to do it while he's not like blur him out in the corner, or he just sits there and have a makeup artist drawing on his nutsack as we're on the air.
Yeah, we gotta get his makeup done.
What if we Photoshop King Croc's cock onto Nutsack Ned's sack?
Ooh, that would be an evil cock
just
right there.
Just a fucking Dragon Ball Z style fusion.
Oh, God. That would be a dirty...
I mean, it would be all right, but I just... I mean, I would be amused for like a second. I don't think it'd be worth the Photoshop.
I know a guy who would paint on some nuts.
Who's that?
Brooks.
Oh, yeah, Brooks absolutely.
Brooks would definitely come on here and paint that guy's nutsack.
That's the guy.
And that reminds me, Cigar Guy, everybody, has taken a mental health road trip vacation. Yep. So he's going to be absent for a while. Maybe forever. We don't know.
We don't really know what's going on. It's, he's going to be visiting his grandparents, and that's what we know so far, and still working for Killer Papers, and I'm sure he's going
to
be fine.
He called me about 20 minutes before the show today mm-hmm. and told me that he's halfway to Albuquerque.
Jesus. Oh, wow.
Mm-hmm. He said, he told me that he's getting over his fear of everything, basically.
Nice.
He's fighting through panic attacks. He's proving to himself that he's stronger than he originally believed. And good for him.
I like it.
I just hope he comes back, though, because he was a great addition to this podcast, a great addition to the crew.
Yeah.
I mean, let's think about it. Cigar Guy shitting his pants in the martial arts video. The video we shot with him this fall is one of my favorites ever.
It's a great video.
Creeptastic Park.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's fun. You liked Creeptastic Park,
I love Creeptastic Park.
The original plan was to get Swolby in there. Swolby, you probably would have been pretty creepy.
You think if some random girl was hitting on you and kind of
try to close the deal?
You would try to close the deal, get a makeout real quick.
I would have tried to like take her to the bathroom and just like nail her out.
Swolby, how has single life been since you had sex with the prostitute Blair?
Oh, dude, good. I feel like I can pound bitches like longer.
Listen, this guy just came back from Mexico and he took a woman. Rosarito.
You took a chick to Rosarito with you?
Yes, dude.
Where'd you meet this girl?
Close the deal.
It's fucked her.
Yeah.
But tell me how we met her, first of all. Let's not get ahead of ourselves.
It's not a new chick. It's just the one we called the other day.
Nice. The one that was really down for you.
Where did you meet her originally? I don't even recall talking about this girl. Yeah. I don't know if I was on drugs that day or if I was just blocking out everything you said.
Why do you have a giant cock, just a figure that makes it... Why don't you glue that to your...
Oh, yeah, man.
Let's talk about where you met this girl.
I met her on Tinder. I met her on Tinder. It took me like 2 days to like go back and forth.
Would you mind that we look at it? Or while you're telling the story, can I look through your Tinder and see what's going on there?
I would love to see that too.
It's fucking horrible.
Swolby, we bought you a hooker. Oh, you owe us that much.
Right, just give us a tin. I just want to look at some of these and you guys talk it out. And I'm going to see what I can find.
Let's see what Melvin, a.k.a. Swolby's strategy is for courting these women.
Dude.
We got to know his courtship. I've seen his thrust strategy and it is effective. But courtship... I mean, that's coupled with the thrust. It's just as important. Swolby, you keep telling the story while Leah pokes around.
So I hit her up, and I get the Snapchat. We get a thing going that we're going to go to a bar. We're going to have a good time.
Uh-huh.
And at this time, she was living with her uncle's family.
That's always bad news, huh?
So we're just sipping, and my only choice is to bang her out in her car. So I just bang her out in the car. I tell her a spot in San Pedro. Uh-huh. We go to the beach, and I'm just fucking. She's riding me reverse cow.
Uh huh. It didn't
take much.
Can we do this? I gotta know, Swolby, how the conversation went in the bar, but I have to piss too because I'm Danny Mullen, and that's what I do. I piss too much. So one pause, real quick here, Austin. Swolby, when you're in the bar with this chick, who you've never met in person before, I imagine you feel some butterflies.
No, not really. I just
did you drink before you showed up?
Yeah, I took 2 shots of whiskey before I went out with her.
That's a cowardly move.
Well, I'm meeting a new person. I don't know if she's going to fucking decapitate me or what.
Let's be real. It wasn't about you being afraid of being decapitated. It was you lacking confidence in yourself.
Well, I wanted to have a steady flow of conversation.
You're a little quiet. Is he quiet or is it just my headphones?
Dude, you want to hear my favorite one so far?
Sure. But let's hear it.
It's really quick. I can't believe this, he writes. She goes, what? The McRib is back. She goes, I hate you.
She says that?
Yeah. And he goes, what's there to hate? LOL. And then she goes, world-class medalist with the fucking drooling emoji. And he goes, I like country music.
That's actually a homegirl that I know from the gym.
I don't get it. World-class what?
medalist, because he's a world-class medalist.
Yeah.
What, a medalist is like a metal fan?
No, and like metal fucking, because he lifts a lot of weights.
Yeah, but that world-class medalist, doesn't he's a world-class medal getter?
That's what he wrote in his bio, clearly. That doesn't mean let's read his bio.
Say gold medal bodybuilder or a fucking record-holding power lifter.
That was 2018 Swoby.
Yeah, you should probably adjust
the bio. He wasn't even Swoby yet.
His bio is
I'm just here for the tacos. Can chug a beer on command. And then he wrote in Denver for the weekend, but you haven't changed that.
Okay,
everybody's
let me see this.
Shit.
Everybody's gonna think you're in Denver, dude.
Well, this is retarded, Swolby. Can chug a beer on command has a bullet point next to it. It's the most prominent line in his bio. Do you think any self-respecting girl? First of all,
he's got a ton of matches.
Yeah. First of all, no girl cares at all whether or not you can chug a beer, but they do care in a bad way that you feel the need to list that in your bio.
I say we rewrite his bio, Danny.
We're
rewriting his bio.
Dude, you sound like a frat guy who's really into like Jimmy Tatro videos.
That's the goal.
Danny, I think we should make a really honest bio about Swolby because, you know, the world is lacking a lot of truth. It's lacking a lot of honesty. I say we make a real sweet, honest bio. For Swolby.
In my defense, I've closed many deals on that Tinder account.
Okay, Leo, you're going to work on
many
this.
Deals.
All right.
You're going to work on this. You got to optimize that, Swolby. That's not good so far.
But if we optimize it, perfect.
The can chug a beer on command? Like, dude,
Swolby, your pictures are good. You look good. I mean, some of these pictures are old.
It can chug a beer on command? That's like a freshman at University of North Dakota's tagline in his Tinder.
And it's working. It's working. He's got those shady thoughts in here, man.
I'm going to go back to his date. So you pregame the date with two shots. You get there. Tell me about the initial interaction. When you guys make eye contact, what do you say? What do you do?
I just tell her, hey, what's up? And then
do you go
like,
in for
hey.
A hug?
She went for a hug.
How tall is she?
She's like an inch taller than me.
Okay. So within reasonable range.
Yeah.
3 inches taller than you becomes a little dicey.
She's about 5'1"?
No. Oh. God damn it, Leo.
I'm sorry. That was me.
I thought Dino was laughing at that joke because it was a funny joke, but of course Dino's just sneezing.
Fuck you,
Dino. Actually doesn't have a good taste in comedy.
Fuck you, Dino.
Kobe.
Okay, so she's 5'1". That was good, Leo. Swolby, so you hug her. You say, what's up?
What's up? Yeah. And then she's telling me that she was she had the day off.
Uh-huh.
Asked her what she did that day.
Uh-huh.
And I barely remember anything after that.
You guys started drinking.
We started drinking.
What were you drinking?
I got an old fashioned.
Nice.
That is a deceptive move. Did you do that to make her think you're classy?
No, because I wanted to keep the whiskey train going. If I started mixing, then I'd just be fucking all over the place.
There's no way you enjoy old fashions.
No, they're good.
Old fashions are awful. The only people who like old fashions are hipsters like Cigar Guy and investment bankers in Manhattan.
Here's the thing. If it's made shittily, I don't fuck with it. I don't like it. It's bad. But if it has the big ass ice cube in there and they like slice the fucking orange and they burn that shit, then it's great.
No,
it's a good
it's
old
awful.
Fashioned.
It is 100% alcohol with a little bit of tang in the flavor. That's all the orange accomplishes. It's disgusting.
Well, it's like a straight whiskey on the rocks, but a little something else.
Swolby, you're insecure sometimes because everybody is when they're in their 20s and they're getting back on the market. And you want the girl to think highly of you. And what happened to chugging a beer on command, by the way?
Well, she got a beer and I got an old fashioned. So I was like, Jesus.
You think she would have liked you more? You think she would have fucked you sooner if you chugged a beer?
Banged her out like right after we left the bar.
How many old fashions does it take and how many beers on her end before she's willing to let you fuck her?
Three rounds.
And then you start making out with her?
Yeah.
You start making out with her in the bar?
No.
Do you get handsy in the bar?
In the car. As soon as we got in the car.
By the way, I love that you guys were driving yourselves after three rounds plus pre-gaming. So you're not getting handsy at all in the bar? That's the move.
He's kind of an animal, Swolby. He can he can drink so much. He came after all that shit. He came to my comedy show and was taking shots and beers and fucking Trulies and old fashions. He was just drinking everything.
Swolby, you're going to perish behind the wheel. We're going to be driving down the 405 and we're going to see your crumpled vehicle on the shoulder. You're going
to
die.
You want to add on to that? That's what I got so far.
Swolby, so you really just kept it completely platonic in the bar. You got outside and then just robotically said, hi, you want to go to San Pedro and fuck?
Not exactly. It wasn't just like an automatic once we leave, I just start grabbing her ass and
how do you build it up?
to the mic. How did I build it up?
Yeah.
Well, I was like, all right, let's go for a ride. Let's, you know, see the ocean.
Oh, my God. Let's you check said
it
out. That?
I like it, dude.
Wasn't it nighttime?
Yeah.
Let's see the ocean at nighttime.
Yeah.
And the you got ocean, that Lexus with 300,000 miles, baby? I love that
like,
shit.
I want to take you.
The ocean at nighttime is just like staring into space minus the stars.
You got the sound.
Awesome. It's black. It's terrible.
Get the romantic sound.
The ocean is doing fun to look at when it's daytime. Okay, so you say, let's go see the ocean. You get behind the wheel with a BAC of probably 0.15. The authorities should have been called. But you drive away from the bar. Yep. What happens then?
We're just parked there. I put some party next door.
Who's that by?
Some black dude that sings R&B.
Just to set real, the mood. Some real right? romantic?
Set the mood.
Is it like, it's one of those R&B songs?
Can you put that song on? I don't care if we get dinged.
Yeah, absolutely. So they, is it like one of those where he opens up talking about sex?
Well, we're going to find out right now, yeah. Leo. Put on Party Next Door by black it. R&B guy.
So as soon as we settle down into the parking space.
Wait, 1 second. I want you to tell me the rest of the story with when the we have this song. Yeah. Because otherwise, we can't fully appreciate the mood.
That's what I got to.
Turn it up.
She's Latina. She doesn't know. She
all right, so you put this song on.
Get wet to that shit.
Ooh. Are they in Seattle?
Is that Seattle?
Space deal. Leo knows. Oh. All right, everybody quiet. Let's listen. This was Saga feel like in the nighttime. Watch what she do when the light shines. Drunk niggas trying to talk in a strip club. Shorty silhouette look like a dollar sign.
That's just how a nigga brought up. The guy just mentioned a strip club in the first three lines.
Wait, my niggas press pause. This isn't R&B. This is straight hip hop.
Yeah, this is not R&B. You want to hear some R&B, dude?
Put on some R. Kelly.
Yeah.
Yeah, put on
But the rest of his discography is just like music to fucking bang out to.
This is my mandate from here on out. Everybody in the crew and everybody who listens to this show needs to put R. Kelly on when they're courting a chick.
I'm down, dude.
Put on R. Kelly.
Ignition Remix is great, dude. That's a great
Ignition's
song.
Ignition's a gem.
Yeah.
To this background, this is way more appropriate, Swolby. We're going to hear the rest of your story.
Yeah, right. Wait. Tell me. We put the song on. Ignition Remix, R. Kelly. Oh, shit. Remix.
Damn.
He's got that stroke game. He's swimming with the stroke game.
Tell me. Turn it down a little bit. I want to hear his mic louder than this song. No disrespect to R. Kelly. He's a great man.
This is great.
Do turn it down a little bit more, Austin, though.
I want you to really feel that shit, all right? Really be romantic about the story, you know? I don't want you to be fucking crass about this shit.
So where do you cross the friendship romance barrier? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Where do you move from a guy she's drinking with to a guy she's about to be hooking up with?
I recline the seats. Start reclining. Turn the music up a little bit. And then I just hit her with the fucking classic arm move.
Ooh.
And then she leans in. I'm like, oh shit.
That is so amateur.
That's what's up.
I love that. She's just like, Danny's just.
And so as soon as I
love
see
it.
That, she leans in. I'm like, fuck it, dude. I'm already fucking. I'm drunk and I'm in.
Uh-huh.
So I just lean for it.
Make out with her.
And it goes straight the tongue.
Straight the tongue.
Yeah, she starts grabbing my schlong.
Are you erect at this point?
Yes.
Okay, you were already chubbed up before you put the arm around her.
I was looking at the ass at the bar.
And Solby got chubbed up when he was getting fucking heckled by two prostitutes and me and you were in the room. Solby's getting chubbed no matter what.
I was fully torqued. And then she starts grabbing it. I start grabbing her titties while we're making out.
Romantic.
I slip a fucking hand into her nipple. I start like,
woo,
getting it hard.
Getting it hard.
Working those knobs, baby. Working those knobs.
And then I just
Dino
hear,
likes
like,
that
moans.
Shit.
She's like,
work the knobs, baby.
She's moaning.
She starts moaning.
She's knocking on orgasm's door just from nipple stimulation.
I wouldn't say just yet.
Okay.
Did you make her come, dude?
Well, let's not get ahead of ourselves.
Let's not get ahead
Leo.
Of ourselves. Sorry, sorry.
So,
sorry.
What happens next?
So. I start reaching, I like grab her closer to make sure that her ass comes out so I can start grabbing booty.
Isn't it tough with a center console in your car?
Well, she was She started to, you know.
Do what?
She started leaning in.
So when did you mercifully escalate to full-blown intercourse?
Well, I said, let's go to the back seat.
Wow.
Damn.
And then she's like, all right.
That was a pimp move.
That was such a pimp move.
Want to go back to my place? You go into the back seat. Mm-hmm. What happens back there?
Play next song.
What
Kelly.
Song is that? Because that last one was fucking awful you played.
Well, yeah, let's play the next song, too.
What
yeah,
song was the one that you played?
Maybe some Drake. I don't fucking know.
You played some Drake.
Some from, like, Take Care album.
All right. All right.
Leo, do you slower. Know what Take Care is?
The album?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, you do. Yeah. We're going to turn everything over to you right now.
Yeah.
Nobody's going to butt in. You got a minute on the mic to tell us what you did to this girl.
All right. So we're in the back seat. I take my fucking condom out. She asked me, do you have any protection? I'm like, yes, I do. And then she just hops on top and starts riding me.
Ooh,
and it wasn't like one of those like
this story's hitting
back
so much
and
better
forth swivel rides. With it was like a bouncing on the fucking dick. Like,
fuck yeah.
For how many minutes?
Like 4 minutes.
Okay, so.
Then I tell her to just turn around. Let me see the fucking booty.
Let you see the booty. How was it looking?
Reverse cow. Nice.
Nice booty.
How's her asshole? Clean?
It looks better pink? Now because she just like. She's been hitting the gym for a steady amount of time.
Her asshole looks better now because she's been hitting the gym?
It helps. It makes a difference,
really?
Leo. They have this new asshole machine at all 24-hour fitnesses.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, it's good. It's just a probe. They stick up your rear end
no
and
way.
It vibrates.
Holy shit.
Really tightens the sphincter.
Wow, and you got to like, oh, I can see how that would really shape the asshole.
And they got an anal bleaching booth there on site, too. It's right next to the juice bar.
Anal bleaching's kind of tight, dude.
Swolby, so you fuck her in the back of your car.
Yeah.
Then you drive drunk to Leo's comedy show, and now you're still fucking this girl. And you took her to Rosarito, Mexico. Do you have a photo of her? Have I already seen her?
No.
Okay, I want to see her. But first of all, let's go through this bio.
Yeah.
Is she as hot as Blair?
This is what I got so far.
Didn't,
Damn.
No.
Blair's hotter?
Blair's hotter.
Damn.
Sure.
Okay, so Leo has crafted a very insulting bio.
No, it's not insulting. It's fucking
Let
truthful.
Me read it. I haven't looked at it at all.
Try
yet.
To be truthful.
It's fucking gnarly.
Yo, what up, mammy? I'm 5'3", so what? You don't like a short king? My cock's 5 inches. Leo, you gotta get some. Leo makes the my cock's 5 inches from the floor joke, but you got to add in some punctuation. There's no punctuation here, which, to be honest, is probably accurate.
I was in character.
But you got to get in the ellipse, the fucking the dot, dot, dot. My cock's 5 inches, dot, 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 from,
from
the floor.
From the floor. I like it.
Short kings, baby. Let me show you my stroke game.
That's what I got so far. I need you to add to
I mean, it's basically said everything that needs to be said. passions. You have to select from pre-written passions?
Dude, you know what?
I wanted to type one up.
His age group is from 18 to 100 plus. Anything.
No discrimination.
Anything that comes to
the MILFs can get
it.
The MILFs can get it.
You ever get some 50-year-olds and shit adding you?
No, very rarely.
Okay. Content creator Melvin. Now, I think you said everything again that there is to be said, Leo.
I think this is going to be a good. It's going to be a good profile for you. And I just want to see what that. I'm just going to follow up this one chick.
Swolby, I was back home this weekend in Sacramento, which is where I used to have to pull stunts like the backseat car fuck all the time.
Yeah.
So,
Danny, I don't know.
Danny,
look
what
at
was
one of his
your,
matches.
I was about to fuck
look
a chick
at
in
one
the
of
car
his
the
matches.
Other night, but then I just got a hotel room.
That's a man, baby.
Swolby, you matched with a muscular African American man.
What the fuck?
You matched with a guy named Lewis.
Yeah, because I know why. Because he's been swiping his ass off. He doesn't even look at the pictures.
I blind swipe.
Yeah,
blind swipe.
Swolby, you got to be careful because people like us are going to go through your Tinder, and we found two men that you matched with.
It's all right. I like pussy. It's no problem.
Okay, he's confident
he's
about
confident.
It. Here's another guy.
Oh, third guy?
Yeah, no, Robert. Look at he fucking matched with Robert, who's a very clearly gay African American.
Wow, how many African American gays are you matching?
Send him a message.
I would love to.
Swolby, I was home this weekend, though, and I was visiting all my stomping grounds where I used to have to take chicks into the park. There was one time. I was in Orangevale Park this weekend, which is right by my house. I tried to hook up with a chick in the bushes there once, and I got bit by a spider.
What?
What?
And you think you got it bad fucking in the backseat of a car? Try to fucking behind an oak tree, dude. That's
were
what
you,
we...
Were you against the oak tree, bending her over, and then the
hell
spider
yeah.
just like Peter Parker'd you?
Dude, I was against the oak tree for sure, yeah. Yeah, I mean, it would have been cool if I got bit by a spider and it gave me some sort of temporary superpower while I was having sex. I don't know. I digress. But being home, dude, I mean, Sacramento, it is the fucking minor leagues, dude.
For the women?
Just for everything. I went to pick up sushi, and I got there early. Oh. They weren't done with our order yet. It was to go. It was for me and my parents to take home. We were just watching football all weekend. It was terrific. But when we were in Mukuni Sushi in Fair Oaks, first of all, two very nice fans came up and shook my hand. That was cool.
In front of the parents?
No.
Have you still fantasized about a couple fans?
Well, for a while, I wanted to get recognized by a fan in front of my dad. So my dad would be like, oh, he's made something of himself. It happened at SoFi Arena. SoFi Stadium, so we went to see the Rams play the Bucks. A middle-aged dude got a photo with me, which is pretty cool.
That is great.
But Mukuni, two fans come by. But when I was sitting there, I chose not to go on my phone, not to get sucked into the world of technology. Mm. I wanted to take in the world of reality in Fair Oaks. And it, Leo, was depressing. Mm. The hostesses were clearly the best-looking girls within a three-mile radius. And they were Leo suck and dump material. Suck Jesus. And dump doesn't have enough. Suck and shuck material. I like that.
Suck well, shuck, and shuck?
Shuck means like you skin them, right?
Jesus, dude. Yeah, so, shucking an oyster.
I would say fucking chuck, but you don't fuck them. You just get blown. They were the types of girls that Leo would DM, get his dick sucked by, and then not talk to again, unless they were willing to be blowjob slaves.
Oh,
that
God.
Was who these girls were. They were just completely dumpy, and they were arranged behind the counter in order of
blowjob
hottest.
Blowjob slaves? I call them blowjob princesses.
No, you don't.
Fucking
that's not what you're
talking friends.
You gotta sell a t-shirt that says suck and shuck.
Suck and shuck. But shucking is fucking stabbing a fucking oyster with a knife in the neck.
Or you can shuck corn.
Yeah, it's a little dark.
It's a little
dark. That's, yeah, that's shucking corn is when you forcefully rip the skin off, right?
Like, shucking is not good.
It's not
a good thing.
But they were arranged. It was like the human evolutionary chart, but it was an order not from least to most evolved. It was an order of from ugliest to hottest behind the counter there, and I was like, this one I would maybe fuck if I was drunk. The one in the middle, it would be oral only after 10 tequila shots. Mm. And the one on the far left, I want dead.
Oh my God.
That was my process with these girls. And then I look over to the bar. It's college football on. And there's just a dude with his fat wife watching the game. And I can tell, like, this guy has preserved himself decently. Mm-hmm. Maybe he works for the local State Farm office. He goes cycling after work, and he's managed to stay in pretty good shape. And his wife is just an ox. She just said, fuck it, 15 years ago, and it shows in every pound of flesh she's unnecessarily packed on. Mm-hmm. And I'm just going, Jesus. And a guy walks in, just obese, the kind of guy who, if he caught COVID-19, would be another statistic, 100%. Mm-hmm. A guy comes in with fucking tattoos. Not that that makes a difference, but you could tell he just, like, works at a local tattoo shop that's got 6 more months
to live. He wasn't thinking about, like, what that snake coiled around his fucking face is going to, like, look like when he's like 80. It's one of those guys.
I like that tattoo idea, just a snake coiled around your face.
You're all the way up, dude.
Yeah, that's you gotta be bald to really it work.
Oh yeah.
But yeah, it's just that's going on. And then you drive around the neighborhood. I go jogging, and there's this guy who has, the sad thing is the house he's living in would be considered wow, you've made it house around here. But in Orangevale, I mean, he probably has a part-time job at the recycling plant.
He's
just out on his front lawn with his big beer belly, smoking a Camel, just watching me jog by the house.
Oh my God.
And I just go, fuck, dude. This is where you move so that your deficiencies don't stand out as much.
Yeah. Most people, they want to stay in that comfort zone. And that's most of America. That's why you eat whatever you want every day. You don't have to worry about looking good for someone. You stop caring about the way you look. It's hard to want to be elite.
It's sounding like every day Leo has to decide, stay in L.A., move to Orangevale.
Oh, God.
Does that sound like a paradise to you? Eat whatever you want, not worry about your looks anymore?
Yeah, I could be like 260 and kind of just like stay at 260 and still be like good enough to pull some chicks in Orangevale.
You would look weird as a fat guy.
I carry it all in like my legs and ass. I would not look good.
It'd be weird. You'd look like a lesbian who works at like a.
I'd look like really like Hagrid. I'd look even more like Hagrid.
You would look like.
I would have to grow out my beard if I was fat.
I'm just imagining like one of those like cool sculpting places or one of those like lightweight plastic surgery places. I feel like they all have fat lesbians and scrubs working behind the desk that carry all their weight on their ass and legs. Mm-hmm. You'd be indistinguishable with your long hair.
Absolutely.
Yeah, you would look like Hagrid.
I would look like Hagrid. It wouldn't be good at all. But I don't think I'm not going to get fat. In fact, I'm going the opposite direction. I got to get leaner into my 40s.
Mm.
I'm going to be leaner and leaner.
Okay, well, that's 5 years from now. We'll see. We'll check in with you in 7 years.
I had it's funny that you're saying that. There's a guy that kind of looks like me if he was a little fatter. It's Queer Eye for the Straight Guy, Jonathan. And I saw him at the Grove, and I was with fucking Brando. It's a very famous gay man. And I missed my opportunity. He said, "Oh my God, your cat." And I was like, "Wait a second. Is that?" And he walked. He had an entourage with him.
First of all,
I fucked up.
It's not cool that you know the cast by name of Queer Eye. And it's really not cool that you were trying to strike up a conversation with one of the cast members.
Dude, this guy, explain yourself. He could give me a shout out. I'd have 15,000 gays.
Why would he do that?
Engage.
Why would he do that? Be like,
"Is that a cute cat?" I don't know. Honestly, I mean, look. All I'm saying is that it was a guy that could help me out, could help the channel a little bit. Yeah. And I didn't take advantage.
Not for free, though.
Not for free. I don't know what I would have done. I mean,
I know what you
would have
done.
I wouldn't have blown him.
You would have followed him to his car.
Stop. No, yeah. I wouldn't.
The shoe would be on the other foot for once.
I would not. He's too proud. I think he has AIDS. I think he's one of those gays with AIDS.
Jesus Christ. Confirmed. Everybody's got AIDS these days, huh?
Like, no, it's not half of them. Stop it. He's only a few guys that have AIDS, but A Queer Eye for the Straight Guys, actually, my ex fucking, we watched like 10 episodes, like over the course of, you know, the years I dated her, and some of them were tear jerkery. They made me cry, Danny. They would get like an old man who didn't care about his looks anymore, and they got him all metrosexualed out. Some of them had like rosacea, and their skin was looking like shit. They hadn't fucked a girl in 20 years, and they helped these guys go on a date and shit. It's really nice.
To come back to the Sacramento thing and to come back to also people letting themselves go like you're talking about, I had to send my buddy Tim a picture of these chicks that me and him went to middle school with and high school with who the dam's broken down, Leo.
Fell off.
Danny, it's so sad to see it. Now, you haven't seen one of your friends with one of those wives yet? Because I have.
They're both on vacation right now, these two chicks. And they're trying to... You could tell they're trying to not let their present form bring them down. They're trying to convey, "Woo, we're on vacation, body positivity. I don't care if we're 120 pounds overweight. We look hot."
Oh,
they're
God.
Taking bikini pics, and it just looks like an elephant seal that slapped on a two-piece.
Oh, come
That's
on.
That's what it looks like. And I sent Tim these pictures, and he was just like, "Oh, my God, dude, this is brutal." And you know, the really sad thing is not that these girls are taking these revealing photos of themselves. I mean, it looks like a second grader tried to draw a circle. That's what their body looks like.
Are you serious?
It is bad, dude. It is just a second grade circle. And the really sad thing is, him and I said, "You and I both fucking know the two relatively handsome guys at 3 a.m. are
going
to take
the
these fucking are going to take these oxen up to their bedroom."
Yeah. You're offering the rod. Any girl gets offered the rod by the end of the night. The ugliest girl in the bar still getting offered the rod.
They're gonna go upstairs.
There's statistics when it comes to like Tinder and stuff that ugly chicks are basically able to fuck still within this top 20 percentile of like attractive men.
Who ran these statistics? Who did this survey?
I can't imagine
Tinder did. Hey, ugly chicks, you want to blow a guy and then get discarded like an edamame shell? You're in luck.
I know a buddy who is friends with an obese OnlyFans girl that, you know, she's for the niche. You know, she's got those people signing up to see that fat pussy.
Oh my God. And we need to put every guy paying her on a list and then slowly start killing those guys.
Stop it. Because a very prominent YouTuber that you and I have hung out with fucks her all the time.
Nice.
Oh my God. I can't tell you afterward.
You know exactly who it is.
Fucks her?
It's the sickest fucker.
How fat is this girl?
Like fucking fat.
Over
dude.
280 or
would,
under?
Would she be on my whale watching boat?
Are you kidding
that I proposed
me? She probably made a post about you when you did the rants.
Me and
guaranteed.
Leo, I think it was on the Patreon podcast, but we proposed a whale watching boat for whales where we put a bunch of fat women on a ship that goes around Catalina. Mm-hmm. And then at one point we just make the bow elevate like the back of a dump truck and we blow the railings off the back of the boat. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah. And by the way, we make sure we chum a bunch of dead sea lion chunks around that patch of sea previously. Mm-hmm. So the water is infested with great whites and they get a feeding frenzy.
We were thinking that that would be a good idea. But
it's
again,
a great idea.
It's a joke. And, you know, once again, we don't need to get fucking... These fat girls have been haunting us. We can't let them fucking continue to haunt us, all right? So
what have they been doing? It's been hilarious.
It's been hilarious.
Do they still come after us?
Yes, absolutely.
Really?
Dude, I had a reporter from the from ABC San Diego. She added me. Right. And within about 2 hours, I'm unadded and she hasn't responded to my last like four messages. And I'm like, hey, what's up? And she's like, you're disgusting. That's all she said. And I was like, did you Google
me? We've
got
like over 2,000 signatures on that cancel the Leo and Danny show.
Yeah, but half of them are a bunch of disguised racial slurs in the form of a first and last name.
That's true.
Half of it is Danny Mullen fans. Oh, just like the common, it's like Nick and then something else at the end that forms a slur or like hairy balls. And that's most of the fucking signatories. It's just Danny Mullen fans trolling it.
That's hilarious. But yeah, man, look, anyway,
hey, the thing about ugly chicks on Tinder, though, is basically guys just don't hardly get any matches compared to girls.
Mm-hmm.
So guys will get so desperate of wanting somebody to swipe back at them, they'll finally get a match, and it'll be a trick that's like a six. And then he's just like, even though he's a relatively attractive guy, he'll go fuck the ugly chick just because, like, that's how dating apps basically work.
Look,
so then ugly chicks are still fucking like pretty attractive guys basically all the time.
Man, look, very chauvinistic of me, but I used to have this thing I used to say in baseball. You don't take batting practice with pearls, which means you don't take batting practice with nice baseballs. You take batting practice with the old baseballs that have maybe gotten some grass stains. Maybe they hit the fence a little too hard. They have a couple of dents. Maybe they're a little waterlogged because somebody left them out.
Leo.
But you still... get to practice.
Waterlogged chicks. Okay.
Some waterlogged baseballs. You still practice, Danny boy.
When I was in SAC this weekend, dude, I beat off to this chick I went to high school with. Who's just super fat and was fat in high school. And I just had, like, for some reason, the fantasy of her just blowing me in my parents' bedroom came into my head.
What is wrong with you?
And I just beat off to it.
Really?
Yeah.
And this girl, does she know you exist anymore?
Yeah, for sure. Right. She, okay, so this
she
girl.
She follows you.
This girl was a legend. She blew, like, everybody in our, she was, I'm trying to think of who the equivalent is. I can think of the equivalent who's blown a bunch of people in the Danny Mullen
group. Funny? Yeah, yeah. So you know what's funny that you would say about a woman like that that blows everybody? They're always married. After, you know what I mean? Is she married?
No.
Okay, thank God.
I get what you're saying, though.
You know, like a lot of those.
They get their sluttiness out and then wedding ring on the finger
a
month after she graduates.
One of the girls that basically banged almost everyone that we knew, like all the athletes at our high school, and then afterward in our friend group, everybody of my high school buddies, she also contracted herpes.
Okay.
And she's married and has 3 children.
Well, I hope her husband's having a good time. He needs a reality check.
Well, Danny, he's probably a very modern man that doesn't, he doesn't slut shame. He doesn't believe in that. It's equality for all.
The first time this girl blew me, and she is, I want to emphasize again, not attractive, was just in the good old days of 2006. Mm-hmm. I remember I'd had a party, maybe a little kickback, and it was just, Leo, you're going to get an erection me just telling you the story.
Oh, God.
But it was like her, me, and then this really hot girl in bed with me.
Ooh.
And I just had the fat one blow me while the other hot one was right next to me in bed.
Was she watching intently and commenting or just kind of pretending she didn't know what was going on?
I have half a mind just to make up a story and make up a monologue so you cream yourself right now. But then so after she blew me there at Tim Meistis's house one time, Tim Meistis was having a kegger, of course. I took the same girl around the side of the house and got blown in the side yard.
Oh,
and then this
God.
Girl came and cock blocked me. What are you doing? Why are you subjecting yourself to this? Grabbed.
What?
I just said this girl's name. Hey, Austin, can you take a timestamp and cut it out?
Wait, I gotta go to work.
Ah, get out of here, dude.
You out of here?
Yeah.
Oh,
good job. Good stuff today, Swolbs.
Hell yeah.
Swolbs, continue getting shady on the weekend so we have some stories.
Yeah, I like it.
Get shady every time.
Swolby, thanks for coming, man. Appreciate it.
Danny, you know, some of the
follow
fans...
Follow Swolby on Instagram,
yeah,
you bastard.
Follow him, dude. He should be getting a fucking 10K already. Come on. Follow the Swolbs.
So you make a note, Austin. So this girl, while my penis is in her mouth, this girl grabs her hand and drags her away. But then another time, you know, college boy?
Mm-hmm. Your best friend.
Dude,
your best
one time I was passed out in Justin Tampas's room,
mm-hmm.
and Fucking Justin Tampas is a guy who died at my high school.
Why would you say his full name like that then? Rest in peace, Justin Tampas.
But I'm on the floor in there, and this girl is blowing College Boy. Oh. College Boy comes in her eye.
What?
And
by,
some of the,
by accident?
And some, yeah, no, on purpose, probably. And some of the jizz shoots past her eyeball and hits me while I'm sleeping on the floor.
Oh, come on. That is so gnarly. Was she like, oh, God, it got in my eye? Or was she like, that was funny? Like, what was her reaction to
that? Both of those reactions sounded kind of positive. Like, yeah. Oh, God, he got in my eye. Or, yeah. Yeah. I think it was probably one of those. Hmm. I know this. She didn't seem to have
some
like
the fans are going
to
say you've gone soft because remember, what I always thought was shocking was the first like 10 episodes we did, you would use first and last names for every one of these wild stories. You're like, so when I was like throat fucking this chick, Jennifer Lawrence, and then all the kids
That's
would
true.
Look her
I
look
did
up.
Throat fuck that one girl. That starlet Jennifer Lawrence, who was an American something.
She's got
the one
facial
with Christian
pics?
Bale.
You ever see her facial pics?
I throat fucked her. What do you mean facial pics? She's got jizz on her face?
Yeah.
An A-list actress has facial jizz?
Ooh, yeah.
That's
with
bad.
The guy, that one actor. Yeah, they were both, they leaked, you know, they hacked her iCloud.
Ooh, my God. Yeah.
They're pretty gnarly. Even Jeter's wife's got nudes that they hacked the iCloud.
Ooh.
Hannah Davis nudes.
How do they hack this shit?
It was something called the Fappening.
Yeah, I remember
it was,
that.
Because they hacked iCloud.
Kate Upton, is she the big titty model?
I think the Kate Upton, too.
Her titties came out.
It was a bunch of
But
that
Kate Upton
nice.
Had Hutchinson. Done topless shit. It's not that gnarly. All the models do some topless, mm-hmm. eventually.
I there might have even been like an Ariana Grande. I know there was a Vanessa Hudgens.
Ariana Grande, not much. I would know. Vanessa Hudgens, yeah, full pussy.
Why would you know about Ariana Grande?
I'm a fan. I like that long hair. I want to pull it while I hit it while I fuck her doggy style. Oh. Can I say that? Is there something wrong with that?
One
She's
thing
married
I learned recently
to a real estate agent, kind of a mid-level real estate agent. He looks a little gay. He mm-hmm. does, to be honest. She could be into that.
Mm-hmm.
But it's honestly kind of shocking that she just married like a mid-level real estate agent.
Yeah, it's tough. I just can't see those. Like when Jennifer Aniston marries the grip on the set of one of her movies, I just can't see these things being sustainable.
Like the one, yeah, the only one is fucking god damn it, Julia Roberts married a camera guy and they're still together.
Julia Roberts is an old hag.
Why would you say that about
Julia
her?
Roberts?
She's
I mean,
so hot.
That's
still.
Like saying my aunt married a camera guy.
No, Julia Roberts, I would so be down to be fucking like I would let her grab my fucking uh-huh. head and push it right down in between her
well,
legs.
Well, you better not have sex with her though, because your baby would be retarded. She's past
she can't
the threshold.
Get pregnant, Danny.
She's probably sure. could.
I want to have sex with a girl with menopause. That is my new goal.
To have sex with a woman who's experienced menopause.
Yes.
You've never done that?
So you never
I don't
had
think
sex
so.
You've never fucked a 50 plus?
I've never had sex with somebody my own age. No, I have gotten blowjobs and handjobs from 50-year-olds, but I've never just doggied a 50-year-old because it's probably, yeah, I would doggy a 50-year-old.
I saw a chick on my Southwest flight yesterday. Older, trashy. I was going to say probably hooked up with a bassist in a hair metal band in the 80s, but I don't want to be offensive to Austin, who yeah, his mom lived that.
Well, we don't know what she did. I think they were all friends, in my opinion.
Oh, yeah.
I believe they were friends.
So you think they were back there doing trust falls and
yeah.
playing Clue?
Absolutely. I think that Jenga was just starting up.
Sure.
You know, so they
sure.
were getting real wild with that sure. Jenga. You ever play Jenga? Dude,
it
gets gnarly.
My mom was dating one of them, so they were in a relationship.
Uh-huh.
Nice.
Uh-huh.
He was for sure.
And
like,
we all know bands like Motley Crue and right. Guns N' Roses, they respected each other's partners, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So. Yeah, of course they did.
My
Danny.
Mom was, I think she dated the drummer of Guns N' Roses,
uh-huh.
and she was like really good friends with the long haired guy from Poison, and that they, whenever he was maybe like 19 or something.
Okay.
Nice.
Really good friends.
Nice.
I just want to say that in the 80s on the Sunset Strip, unprotected anal sex was the equivalent of a handshake.
I think she may have like known him in Texas or something like that.
Dude,
unprotected anal was a handshake.
Dude,
huh?
I read the Motley Crue book, The Dirt, which is way better than the movie could ever. The movie was relatively gnarly for being on Netflix and being a mainstream project.
Yeah.
But the book, first of all, it basically opens with a rape scene.
Jesus.
It basically opens with Motley Crue, before they were big, hosting a crappy apartment party in Hollywood right after one of their little gigs. They have a groupie girl in the closet. I think Nikki Sixx is in there first, taking his turn. He leaves the closet, sends Tommy Lee in there. The girl still thinks it's Nikki Sixx, fucks him. Tommy Lee goes out to the living room, retrieves a 13-year-old younger brother
Jesus.
Of one of the partygoers, sends him in there, and the 13-year-old fucks this 20-year-old groupie. Then also, Tommy Lee, this is one of the most mind-boggling stories I've heard ever. Tommy Lee's fiance and him are in a hot tub in the Hollywood Hills with a bunch of record execs, a bunch of other musicians. Tommy Lee pops up on the edge of the hot tub with his big 12-inch boner and says, "Suck my cock, bitch." Verbatim. That's how it appears in the text. She sucks his dick. He comes. Then he makes her go around the perimeter of the hot tub, sucking every willing penis that's there.
Would you have been one of the guys that took your cock out?
Yep. Absolutely, especially if you caught me in my single days.
Soul she goes would around one of the guys too.
Oh, 100%. She sucks 12 guys' dicks, then comes back around to Tommy. She sucks him again, he comes, and then he makes her go around the horn once more.
No fucking way. And then married her.
Yeah, her last name was Schlosser, is the crazy thing.
Oh, nice.
Thanks. Son of a bitch.
It's possible. I'm sorry, Austin.
You said, no, so she was already married to Austin's father.
I was going to say.
Yo, I have a great Tinder story.
If only I knew her maiden name, Leo. What's that?
So I had lost my virginity to this chick and then dated her for a long time. And then after we broke up, I downloaded Tinder to try to get some pussy. And there was this pretty hot emo chick. And we ended up going inside this pretty nice neighborhood in the middle of my hometown. There's this small lake. And so there's suburban houses right there. It's hardly a lake. It's more of a nature preserve type thing. Mm-hmm. And me and her are in my hammock making out. And then eventually we start fucking. And then right when we finish fucking, this guy in full camo in his mid 50s or 40s. And a .22 rifle in a beard just pops up next to us in the fucking woods.
How'd you know it was a .22?
Because he stayed there and talked to us. Mm. And he was I like to come out here sometimes with my .22 and do a little hunting, even though you're not really supposed to.
That's so scary.
You're fucking killing ducks and shit in our neighborhood? Sneaking up on me in the middle at 2 o'clock in the morning with a gun.
That's creepy, yeah, dude. That's you awful. Guys almost got killed.
I was terrified. But then the guy ended up being really cool. Mm-hmm. He said he was a professional bass fisherman, mm-hmm. and he was showing us all these pictures of him and his son catching bass on this fancy boat.
And he helped you dispose of the body?
Dude, I literally thought I was going to fucking die.
How many times did your girlfriend have to blow him before, or that girl have to blow him before you left?
None, but I never talked to this girl again because
listen, Mary Jane, all the small talk, I gotta cut it out now. I'm not leaving until you suck my dick. And if you says no, my .22 rifle's gonna say yes.
It's fucking scary, dude.
It was a message from God telling me to get my act together.
You could have, yeah.
Afterwards,
he was gonna...
that chick told me that she was a fucking witch and what? She cast spells and shit.
Yeah, I've had some witches in my day.
Is that really that big of a turnoff to you, Austin? You cast spells in Minecraft every night for 16 hours when you go home.
I don't know. I'm just saying that dark energy followed that chick. It fucking summoned that bearded camo guy.
Yeah, who was a champion bass fisherman. Doesn't sound too bad.
God damn.
He was cool. It was just scary at first.
I'd be scared. If he had killed both of you right there and just buried you guys out there, how long till the cops found you guys?
It would take... the next morning, some jogger would find us. Or there were people sleeping in hammocks, just further down the... because this is a place where everybody goes hammocking. Fucking guy is going around the
hammock. You ever been hammocking, Dan?
No, absolutely not.
We should go hammocking for a video.
Hammocks suck. Is there any more vulnerable position to be in than lying in a hammock?
No, it gets you off the ground, which apparently, according to Survivor Man, is what you need to do in certain terrains.
Why?
Well, because the bugs are down there, Danny. The bugs, the snakes...
And the panthers. Ground sucks the heat out of you.
The panthers.
All you need, if you see your enemy in a hammock, if you stumble across your enemy in a hammock, all you need is a staple gun. You run up, you clasp the two ends of the hammock over the person, staple gun it, and boom.
I think we need to do nothing but work on staple gunning Dino into a hammock from now on.
We should work on this. We should get Mudflap into a hammock. No, that's going to require heavy equipment to move him once we got him in the cocoon. We can't get these guys. That's the problem with this podcast. We come up with these brilliant ideas, yep. but these guys are in the room with us, so we can't pull the shit.
We can't fuck with Dino.
We're going to have to get Neeks in a hammock, which won't be difficult. Encourage him to drink, and I'm sure he'll pass out there happily. Yeah. Then we fucking... My dad, dude... he was telling me stories about the shit they used to do in college.
Gnarly back in the day, huh?
I thought I was a renegade when I was at UCLA because I would do shit like get a guy's mattress, throw it out the window. I would fuck chicks in the middle of the fraternity house, shit on the floor. There was this guy who my dad went to college with. First of all my dad's friends have just legendary names. There's one of his buddies is Pat Morrissey. Then there's Tim Wolf. There's Dean Heydrich, the legend.
Wow.
But one of these guys, it might have been Pat Morrissey, was the heir of, not $1 billion, but his dad's a multi-millionaire, has more money than anybody else in Reno, which is where my dad went to college. This guy had a Cessna. He had his own private plane, this kid, would fly over the campus with water balloons in the middle of the day and just water balloon people.
What?
In a fucking plane!
No.
Yes! And they told, my dad tells me a story that he's in this bar. It's a Native American bar. They cut him off one day, which to get cut off in a Native American bar is a miracle. I mean, he should probably be turned into a saint for managing that task. But he gets so pissed that they stop serving him his Jack and Cokes that he leaves the bar, goes home, retrieves a gas-powered chainsaw.
Oh, God.
Comes back in, fires it up, and saws the bar in half.
Come on.
However, before he can get a clean cut down the bar, the chainsaw runs out of gas. See, while it's still gassed up and going, all the Native Americans in there are understandably keeping their distance. Nobody's intervening. But when that thing sputters, Squanto and Big Tree, they start feeling a little bolder about this whole thing. They run over to Pat Morrissey and beat the ever-loving shit out of him.
Oh, yeah.
They fuck him up so bad, Leo. And Pat Morrissey, I guess, perished 3 years later in a head-on collision with a BAC of 0.3.
Oh, man.
They needed his dental records to identify him. And I guess to this day, there is a plaque in that bar in honor of him. The Native Americans made a plaque and put it on the bar telling the story about the time he came in and tried to saw it in half.
What the fuck, man?
Dude, they were unbelievable. They were way gnarlier than us.
Can you imagine what we would have done if, like, nobody would, they couldn't find us online or there wasn't any way to, like, contact somebody to, like, get people canceled? Like, can you imagine?
I can't imagine because I basically did it in college.
Exactly, yeah. You were still in the era where you could do it, yeah.
I have been thinking about this, and I think part of it is the paywall system. Of, like, before, if you wanted to kind of share clips and stuff of people saying or doing things that were, like, over the top, you would have to go through the paywall, actually watch their show or whatever. Everything just wasn't, like, free on the internet.
What are you talking about? At what point in time did you have to pay to see somebody doing something stupid on the internet?
Any time before the internet. What I'm saying, like, DVDs and stuff, TV, like... Yeah, now, but, like, you but can get away with stuff if you have your own website where there's a paywall.
No, what we're talking about, the shit my dad was doing, they weren't filming.
Right.
They weren't selling Girls Gone Wild style VHS tapes.
Well, like, the guy with the chainsaw, nobody had, it was all word of mouth. Like, they didn't have a camera there to just be like, look what this fucking guy's doing. Let me put it on some big place where a bunch of people will share it. Like, there was no... Yeah, they couldn't send it in the mail, you know what I mean, or something?
I was just referring to, because you were talking about how people used to just be totally different back then, and they could be all crazy. Well, now we just have this, like, hyper, you can find anything like that really quickly. Shit just spreads because of the internet, and it's all free to watch.
I mean, it's mostly because of phones, and it's mostly because social media has led to cancel culture and led to people attacking everybody on Twitter for stepping one toe out of line.
Right. Such bullshit.
I think it's mostly phones, Austin, because it would have required $20,000 at that time worth of camera equipment to capture Pat Morrissey sawing the bar in half.
Yeah.
Also, they would do shit, too. My dad was telling me a story that, like, they all went to the whorehouse. My dad, Dean Heydrich, Pat fucking whatever his name is, and Rob Wolf, they all go to the whorehouse. They're too drunk to drive home afterwards, so they deflate their tires, drive the car up onto the train track, and they deflate their tires so that the hubcaps rest perfectly on the tracks.
Come on.
And they just drive home like they're a choo-choo train.
Well, no.
That was considered the safer alternative.
Yes! And a cop finds them, and just all the cop does is make them pull into a filling station, pump their tires up, and drive home.
What?
Nobody gave a shit.
Holy fucking shit.
My dad was saying, too, that part of the initiation to get into his fraternity, he was in Sigma Alpha Epsilon. A brother in the fraternity had to drink himself green to the gills, meaning nauseous, about to vomit. And then once he was about to vomit, a pledge got underneath him, fell to his knees, opened his mouth, and got puked in by the brother, baby bird style.
No.
Yep.
What? Your father is you. That's the point of the story. Your father one-upped you.
He might have been way gnarlier than me.
He is clearly gnarlier than you.
He
might have
been
even believe this shit.
I mean, I did some wild stuff in college, but I mean, at the end of the day, I tried to avoid ending up in the slammer.
Yeah.
I did end up in the slammer once, but it sounds like my dad...
They roughed you up in the slammer, in fact.
A little bit, yeah. I tried to call my dad from the slammer. I was like, you fuck ass, I'm going to call my dad. He's a judge.
And fucked you up.
Two officers just stormed, descended upon me, got my arms behind my back, and threw me in solitary.
I love it.
Yeah,
that's what you deserve, you sick bastard.
I did.
So your dad was fucking out of control.
He was.
And then what, he settled down one day? Do you think he was a ladies' man? He must have been.
I think he was getting some pussy.
I think so. You know what else is tall? He's 6'4".
I know we've covered this too, but it's such bullshit. My fucking grandpa played for the Green Bay Packers.
I know, that's gnarly.
My dad's build, he could have played football.
I know.
Look at me, I can't play football for shit.
Well, yeah, I mean, yeah, I guess you would have put in, I think you might have been a decent baseball pitcher because you do have leg strength.
I don't think so.
I felt it around my neck that one time in Vegas. You were hammered.
But yeah, that's a different kind of leg strength.
Pitchers they don't have to be fast. They don't have to be. But your build is like, there's a lot of pitchers in the bigs that are about your height and build.
There we are. Austin, how long have we been recording for?
An hour 25.
Hour 25? Any last thoughts to wrap on here, guys? What are we going to talk about?
I mean, whatever you want, my man. What do you want to talk about?
I don't know.
I guess we could. You want to end it on a little pranky prank phone call?
Sure, yeah. Let's get some of that going.
You want to call the old place you used to work? Not a hotel in Vegas?
Sure. Dino, you just grabbed a microphone. What were you going to say?
Let's talk about bees. Bees nuts?
Nobody fell for it.
God damn it, Dino.
And also, bees isn't D's.
Yeah,
so.
Dino, what the fuck was that, dude? God.
I said D's, you would know.
All right, what are we doing? What's the angle? Let's have should Dino come up with a concept for this prank phone call to a hotel in Vegas?
Why? I gotta know, Leo. Are you just prepared to call the Encore in Vegas all of a sudden?
Because they answer right away, and it's funny.
The Encore? What about Caesars? What about the Flamingo?
You want to call Caesars? You want to call the Flamingo?
I'm confused because Leo came in here. He's like, bro, we can call this insurance company. Or the Encore and nothing else.
I've called the MGM and they have one of those automated systems. It's not as it's not as fucking streamlined.
Yeah, yeah.
You call the Encore, they fucking go, hi, how can I help you?
Yeah, the way Vegas works is the MGM it's like Rockefeller's oil company. It's just an evil corporation that is buying up the entire strip. Almost every casino on the strip, even if it isn't MGM, it's MGM.
Of course.
The Mirage is MGM. Mandalay is MGM. MGM is MGM, obviously. But there are a couple of little boutique... boutique makes them sound small and mom and pop owned. They still have ridiculous capital behind them. But the Cosmo and the Wynn Encore are two privately owned casinos in Vegas that are by far the nicest. And they're not as corporate as the MGM properties. So that's why the service is so good.
They have that new hotel that they built, the Circa... on Fremont, and that one's really tight. It's like...
Who built it?
It's the...
It's probably such a piece of shit.
It's a private one. The guy owns three other casinos in Vegas. But the Circa, it's like really technologically advanced because it's the newest casino that they built. They have these massive screens for watching football
on.
They have this, like, four pools that go like this, and then a giant TV where you can watch all the games and shit, and... like, nobody's ever there, and it's just this giant pool.
If you're looking for a place to stay in Las Vegas, you could do worse than the place that has four pools that go like this. The fuck does that mean?
Okay,
why do I want four pools, and what does going like this entail?
Well, there's like a pool, and then you go down a level, and there's another pool. It's like it's almost like a big...
Austin, holy shit. What an awful sales pitch. Steve Wynn used to do all the ads for the Wynn Encore, and he'd be up on the edge... of his building. And sometimes even old Blue Eyes, Frank Sinatra, would be in the ads with him. Those
old
were
blue eyes.
That motherfucker knew how to sell a casino. You missed it because you were trying to call the casino. Yeah. Austin just gave me the worst sales pitch. I know this casino sucks because Austin thinks it's cool. Mm. Austin, in the eyes of Las Vegas, you are a June bug. You are a mosquito. Nobody who's important wants you at their resort. So if you value a resort, I know it sucks. He's like, Danny, there's this new really sick resort on the strip. It's got like a big screen, and there's like a pool, and there's like two more pools that go like this, and there's like a bed in the room. And, fuck this place. What's it called?
It's called Circa. No. It's cool.
No.
See, I just tried to call the Flamingo because it'd be kind of funny to talk shit to the Flamingo, but they have a whole automated system. See, the Encore, they just fucking answer.
See,
it's fun to find phone numbers that people just answer.
If you go to one of the other casinos owned by the same company, this is what Jerry did. He goes to the D, which is like the shittiest, like grossest hotel basically you can go to.
Well,
but
he feels
it
at home there. Yeah,
he loves it.
It reminds him of his apartment.
And if you have roaches. A room at the D, then you can go to the like the resort stuff at the other hotel, Circa. Uh-huh. So that was the play that we did. We went to the shitty hotel so that we could go to the cool hotel's pool and stuff, mm-hmm. and act like we were rich. It's a fan Jerry technique.
Okay, we were talking about the Wynn Encore and the Cosmopolitan. You know how nice those hotels are? OJ, his first stop after he got released from prison was to go straight to the Cosmo.
Wow.
He got banned 6 hours later. He got banned from the Cosmopolitan.
That's bullshit.
Like instantly when he got released from prison. Do you think OJ Simpson would ever be caught, sorry for the pun, dead at the Circa?
Nah, but Fan Jerry, dude. Like if you're on a Fan Jerry budget, you know,
I wonder if Fan Jerry is ever just going to plunge a steak knife into a girl.
What the fuck, dude?
Is that really that absurd to wonder about?
I don't think he's violent. I don't see the violence in Fan Jerry's eyes. But
20
maybe
years down the road, he's married. He's got a couple of kids. They're having trouble making the mortgage. You can't see him going for, let's face it, he probably won't be able to maintain his knives very well. I'm sure he washes them in the regular machine. Mm-hmm. I'm sure they wouldn't even be that sharp. Mm-hmm. But you couldn't see him going for one and just plunging it into his wife's chest plate.
If you change the image in your mind from a murder to a murder-suicide, it makes a lot more sense.
Oh, my God. Fan Jerry is going to have – he's going to get clean. He's going to fix his teeth. He's going to get fucking educated, and he's going to be great. He might even have a stand-up career. Who knows?
Hmm. Do you think he's ever going to stop talking shit about me on his live streams?
Probably not. Nobody knows why, but whatever. It is what it is.
He has a pretty decent job.
Yeah, he's got a good job. He's fine. He'll work there for a while. He'll get his retirement.
You don't think he's going to show up at work with a little companion of his tucked away in his attaché case?
Oh, my God. I don't think he'll go. I don't think he's going to. No, I do not think Fan Jerry's got a violent bone in him. I think that.
I don't think.
You don't think Fan Jerry would ever snap after his manager calls him at 7 p.m. on a Thursday, after Fan Jerry thinks he's done with work, he's loaded up and ripped 3 full bong bowls, he's ready to start watching whatever the fuck garbage on Netflix or YouTube. His manager calls him up, Mr. Cynical, I'm really sorry to tell you this. We just got the Anderson report in. I'm going to need you to go through it, make sure all the numbers check out, and if anything's wrong, recalibrate it. Shouldn't take more than 3 hours. Enjoy. You don't think Fan Jerry on Friday morn at 7 a.m.,
Just fucking loses it.
I think he walks in there. I can picture it in my head as if it's a movie. The camera is down at the floor, and you just see combat boots step into frame.
Oh my God. And then it slowly pans up.
It pans up. He's wearing his military uniform,
but
from
with
Fan
a tank.
Jerry Marine days.
But it's with a tank. I think he's got the military pants and like maybe like a vest, but he's got his arms out. You know how he always has his arms out.
He's got the arms out. He's got his dog tags around his neck.
Oh yeah,
he's got his dishonorable discharge paperwork.
Yeah,
safety pinned to his chest.
I like that safety pin. Yeah, because like that's a big fuck you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. He's wearing a helmet. Mm-hmm. His standard issue Marine Corps helmet and aviators, and he's smoking a big cigar, an expensive cigar. He broke the bank on it because he knows this is going to be his last day ever.
A rare Cuban.
Mm-hmm. It's lit. He's puffing. Mm-hmm. And the secretary, when he first walked in, was like, Mr. Cynical, can you mind putting that out? And he just blew a cloud of smoke in her face. And he said, listen up, Gash. If you know what's good for you, because Fan Jerry, he's got a soft spot for the ladies.
Right.
If you know what's good for you, you'll take an early lunch break.
Right.
And then he opened up his attaché case real quick and showed her what was inside. And she went, ah! And she ran for help. Mm. But Fan Jerry knows. help's not going to arrive in time.
Nope.
So we go back to him stalking through the cubicles.
Oh my God, dude.
He's got with him a gas power AR-15 with a sawed off stock.
Oh,
he's even sawed off the barrel too, because his attache case is only 15 inches wide.
He's got the dog on a chain with him too. He's walking. The dog's walking.
He's got the dog. He's got his bearded dragon perched on his shoulder.
His bearded. All the animals are with him. The dead tarantula that we made, we paid him to throw on the ground.
Yep.
He's carrying that. He's got a little case for it. It's in his pocket.
You know what he's got? He went to Papa John's Pizza. He went to the quarter machines. And he put in a quarter for one of those little fake wedding rings that comes out of the little plastic orb. Mm. He put the tarantula corpse in the plastic orb.
Yeah, and he, yes.
And he made it into a necklace. So
yes.
It's his dog tags. He's got the dead tarantula.
Yeah.
And he's still just smiling and smoking the cigar.
Yes.
And he walks right up to his boss.
The little snake, dude. He's got the little snake.
Right. He's got the snake, too.
Oh, yeah.
The dead snake.
The dead snake.
The dead snake's in the orb, too.
Oh, yeah.
He walks right up to his boss, Mr. Goldstein.
Goldstein's like, oh, fantastic. Was it Halloween? You're going to some kind of costume party? What's going on?
You look ridiculous. By the way, you got that calibration paperwork I asked for last night?
Yeah, hurry up. Make it snappy. I got to go. I got to leave early, catch the Dodgers game. So fucking hurry up.
Yeah.
You fat fuck.
They're in the playoffs.
He says something about his weight, too. He goes, oh, you look a little portly. You should value your health in this company. You know, if you want long-term growth in this company, you got to value your health, Fangieri. Mm-hmm. You got to value that health, Fangieri.
And Fangieri's response to that.
Oh,
it isn't a verbal response.
Oh, no.
All you hear is, ch-ch-ch.
Whoa, what's going on here?
Fangieri empties an entire clip on his boss.
And then the next thing would be they would sensationalize Fangieri's life. All of our videos would blow up with Fangieri in them, and they would all blame you for the horrible bullying. But really not. I mean, we got to talk about the behind-the-scenes pussy that Fangieri's gotten from the channel, because that would really help. You know, it would really help strengthen the argument that we were trying to help him.
And we also got to talk about the quote-unquote bullying. Yeah. As if not everybody in the crew gets shit. I mean, everybody
we
in the crew
do.
Is...
It's comedy. Yeah.
And
it's
also,
comedy.
Also, by the way, I feel like one of the last things Fangieri did in a video was try to fuck my girlfriend. I don't know if that's bullying, but that seems like a betrayal of trust.
He's trying to fuck your girlfriend,
yeah.
Yes. And you know what? He was charming in there. I liked his approach.
Mm-hmm.
He wasn't successful, but yeah, you know, I mean, I could see why you have a bone to pick with him.
It's
It's
not a bone to pick. I have no bone to pick with Fangieri. I just think it's ridiculous that he, for basically no reason, has been talking shit about me all over the place, every conceivable location where one can talk shit.
Yeah.
He's found it and talked shit there, most notably on TikTok.
Yeah.
And you know what? I wish him the best in his stand-up debut.
It'll be funny.
And I hope that the situation that we just described, where he stalks into his office with a gas power, sawed-off AR-15.
I don't think it's going to happen.
I hope
starts dishonorably discharging people.
Yeah, dishonorably discharging shells. Do you think he would only shoot up his boss, or do you think he would take everybody with him? I think anybody who is subscribed to Just Jerry on YouTube would be spared.
Oh, yeah.
And
those people in the office who were like, oh, I subscribed to your YouTube channel, Jerry. You know, like the guy in the mail room, or maybe one of the receptionists, maybe one of the assistants, you know. Oh, yeah, I'm subscribed.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think was going to do a mass shooting that, like, the gut instinct for most people would be to immediately run away, or just like, oh, we can probably stop this guy.
I mean,
he would just get stopped.
What would stop Fangieri?
Does anybody think they can take on an AR-15?
But what would stop Fangieri?
You're in a room with like 10 people, and then you see Fangieri walk in, and you're like relatively big. You're like, oh, okay, we can just grab this guy.
I'd be
maybe one
scared.
Person would get shot.
if you saw Fangieri walk into your place of work with an army helmet assault rifle,
but if he had no,
I am jumping
the
out the window.
Dragon,
I don't care if I'm on the 15th floor.
Yeah,
well,
the bearded dragon on the shoulder would really.
Do have at least one guy who charges directly at the shooter and tries to stop them, and a
they
lot
do?
Of times they
That's
do.
That's encouraging.
Stop. Yeah, dude, there was this black guy. He like grabbed the barrel of the gun as the guy was shooting and like pulled it away and then like burned his hands and like shot the guy. Like,
well, that's fucking sweet. Where was that?
I think it was inside of like a KFC or something.
They need to fucking blow
that
guy
I feel like
that
would have been more publicized.
They don't publicize the heroes, Danny.
Austin just nodded off one afternoon after smoking 3 blunts and he had this daydream.
I wish you could Google this.
There are other times where people in Texas will go to churches trying to shoot him up, and you'll have this guy.
Well, that happened. I saw that one. They were just someone. Yeah, it was just like a Western. The guy was like, "What you doing over there?" Got him.
From across the church.
Mm-hmm.
And that happens a few times. They just don't talk about those very often.
Should we just call the encore and just to end it and say, like, tell them about the worst stay we've ever had?
Sure.
Complain about it?
Sure. We'll just give them a call. We'll call the encore. We've talked enough about Vegas. People need to hear the voice of the front desk lady at the encore.
Yeah, right. Not my shitty take.
You want me to just text it to you or just say it out loud? I'd rather text it. It's kind
of. I think you can give out the public number of the encore. I think it's all right.
Are you ready, Austin?
Oh, do you want to just call him on that side?
What do you mean? Just call him from here? Because we could just do that.
The encore, when I worked there, the employee dining room, holy shit, is it good.
Yeah?
It's a great place to work, actually.
Really?
Yeah, absolutely.
Get a lot of food, a lot of...
I got scolded. They constantly had to send notes up to my supervisor. Like, this kid's going to... You can only go to the EDR once a day, and he's showing up 3-4 times a day and loading up his plate. But they would never do anything other than just bitch about it. They weren't about to fire me.
Yeah.
And dude, I mean, they had pork chops, Leo. They had steak cooked to perfection. Just maybe a minute past being red still in the center. They just left it in a little bit longer on. I don't even know how they prepare the steak. But it was, you know what I'm saying. It was perfect steak color. Yeah. Medium rare. Yeah. And just melt in your mouth.
Got some talented chefs.
Vegetables. And you would be in there too. And while you were eating, yeah, you would see all the card dealers and the slumped over janitors. But you would also see the cocktail server girls.
Ooh.
And also, did I mention my restaurant was adjacent to the top pool? That was a perk. That was a fucking perk.
Wait, what?
Yeah, there was a topless pool.
Was it that Sapphire Club or whatever?
I don't know what it was called, but the Wynn Encore has an adult topless pool.
That's crazy.
Most of the time, nobody takes them, meaning the resort, up on it and gets topless. But occasionally, a swinger chick would fly in from out of town with like a rich 10 years older than her husband, and she would just have her fake tits out on display for all.
Okay, so I got something I'm gonna do. I'm not gonna tell you what I'm gonna do on this, but you have to go with whatever I go with.
I like it.
I thought you were like, I gotta go there.
Shh.
This is
how you doing? I got just a little question for you. One of my friends, his name is Hugh. He went down to the Encore last year. He told me he got one of them rooms, and the view from his room was. He was telling me he had so many titties within eye distance that it was just shocking. And I was wondering if I could get that same room. And me and my partner, we're real excited to go to Vegas. My partner over here, he's never been to Vegas here. He won't say what's up so we know. Just, this lady's going to take care of us.
Yeah, I'm sorry, miss. I think it was a room up above the topless pool y'all have out there in the pool.
Yes. The European pool. So allow me to connect you with our reservations department, and then they can help you to select the room and your reservation for you.
Yeah. Do you need my first and last name? The last name is Jazz.
One moment. I'm the operator. I'm going to give you over to reservations, okay?
Sure.
I'm fucking pumped about them titties. Tell you what.
All right,
pumped about them titties.
I'll wait.
They're so quick, dude. The Encore is just a fucking legendary hotel. Reservations.
Thank you for calling Wynn Las Vegas and Encore. All of our agents are currently busy assisting other guests.
Fuckers.
To access current rates and other resort information quickly, please visit us online at WynnLasVegas.com and EncoreLasVegas.com.
I say we just call the front desk again and
sure.
There'll be a new person and be like, we got it, and then just hit it again, yeah?
Las Vegas, this is
Abby, director. I want to get one of them rooms right above the European pool.
Okay, thank you. I'll connect you with the reservation.
I got connected over there, and I got the busy signal.
Ask her how close we get to them titties.
How close can we get to the European pool?
Okay, one moment, sir. Let me check the line.
Well,
she must get these fucking questions all the time, dude.
I highly doubt that.
Dude, the way she's reacting, it seems like she might. Dina, you want to go to the European pool with me, buddy? Do we have to have our cocks out?
Is it gay to look at titties together?
Gay?
There we go. I knew he'd find a way.
Is it gay to look at titties together? Dino, you want to go to a strip club with me?
No, I don't like strip clubs.
Neither do I. This is going to be good. Come on. God damn it. Next call, we're just telling her off at the front desk.
Thank you for calling Winlock.
Oh, this is bullshit.
It's done, dude. We can't get
We can't call her back and just tell her off. Be like, the hell you think
that's,
you're doing?
That's on you. I got nothing on this one.
All right. I'm going to fucking call her back and then.
Is that real gold, that necklace?
No. It was $10. Do you want it?
No.
Thank you for calling Winlock Las Vegas.
Listen, you keep sending us down some rabbit hole where it ends up, where I ain't seeing no titties. I don't know what the hell you thinking.
Okay.
But
sir,
I'm trying to make that reservation.
Room?
I'm sorry, man. I'm being real stressed. They make me get vaxxed at work, and I just lost my job. I work for Southwest Airlines, and I don't know, man. I'm being real stressed, and the only thing's going to make me feel better is some bouncy titties in my face, man. But I'm sorry. I'm sorry I'm being hostile, you know what I'm saying?
All right, that's the Leo and Danny
that's
show.
The Leo and Danny
show. We're not going to be able to get a room. Unfortunately.
At the encore.
The glass is interfering with my binoculars.
God damn it.
All right. You guys have a great day.